So the next and the last topic is 3.9 Steel Scrap Recycling Policy. Why news? Recently, Ministry of Steel issued the Steel Scrap Recycling Policy. Need of Steel Scrap Recycling Policy. First is useful waste. Steel scrap is a recyclable material left over from steel manufacture or fabrication or at end of life of the product. Steel scrap is unique that it is 100% recyclable. It can be used, reused, recycled infinitely. Okay, so steel does not change its properties, its composition over a period of time. It remains the same and hence can be recycled infinitely. When iron ore remains the primary source of steel making, used or reused steel in the form of scrap is the secondary raw material for the steel industry. So what is the primary raw material for steel industry? Iron ore. And what's the secondary raw material? Scrap. Okay. Steel production processes. Now there are three kinds of steel production processes. First one is blast furnace. Okay. Most of the major steel producers operate through blast furnace, that is basic oxygen furnace. Blast furnaces convert iron ore into hot metal. Okay, hot metal, obviously in which form? Liquid form, and then it is converted to steel. So this is in the liquid form. You can also convert it into pig iron, which is the solid form. Okay. Next method is electric arc furnace. This uses 100% scrap as input metal along with lime and dolomite, which are slag formers. This greatly reduces the energy required to make steel when compared to primary steel making using iron ore. So it reduces the energy required to make steel. Third is induction furnace. Initially, induction furnaces were used for melting stainless steel scrap. Okay, so it melts the stainless steel scrap. But what is the problem in this? It lacks refining the steel. But it is most cost effective technique among the three. Okay, but the only problem is it lacks refining. It just melts the stainless steel scrap. So we saw the three processes. Next point, to regulate scrap industry, interventions are required to accord industry or infrastructure status to unorganized scrap recycling sector so as to ensure statutory compliance with respect to safety, health and environmental norms in collection and processing of scrap. So until and unless the status of industry or infrastructure is accorded to these industries and they are brought under statutory compliance, it is only then that safety, health and environmental norms will be followed in the collection and processing of scrap by these industries. There is very limited adherence to policies on safe dismantling and also low investment in infrastructure for safe disposal of waste materials. So currently there is low safety and there are no proper norms, so there is limited adherence. So everything, first of all, they have to be accorded as an industry or infrastructure, status needs to be given to them, and then they need to be brought under statutory compliance. To improve steel production and reduce import bill. So current supply of scrap is how much? 25 million from domestic unorganized scrap industry and 7 from the import of scrap. Okay, so 25 million tons we get from domestic and remaining 7 million tons is imported. So what they are trying to say in this point is we don't need to import this, and even this 7 million tons can be acquired from the domestic industry itself. Most of the major steel producing countries like Japan, USA, China continuously increasing scrap based steel production with proportionate reduction from primary route. So now instead of using the primary iron ore, everybody is shifting to secondary raw material, that is scrap. National Steel Policy 2017 also aims to develop a globally competitive steel industry by creating 300 million third party administrators steel production capacity by 2030. So basically we want to increase it to 300 million. Okay. There is also higher scrap availability due to increasing per capita steel consumption. So currently why there is higher scrap availability and why they are saying is we have the potential to harness the 7 million tons of scrap from domestically itself is because our per capita consumption of steel, which was 33 kg in 2004, has now increased to 60 kg. So per capita steel consumption is 60 kg. Next is environmental benefits. Recycling steel requires 56% less energy than producing steel from iron ore. 56% less energy it requires, plus it reduces CO2 consumptions by 58%. Okay, what are the key features of steel scrap recycling policy? First is, it is environment friendly. Promotion, collection, processing, recycling of products in an organized, safe and environmental friendly manner. The policy also proposed to create a mechanism for treating waste streams and residues produced from dismantling and shredding facilities in compliance to hazardous and other waste management and transboundary movement rules 2016. So these dismantling and shredding facilities have to comply, while they are treating these waste streams and residues, they have to comply by these hazardous and other waste management transboundary movement rules 2016. Next point is, promote circular economy. The policy envisions promoting circular economy. So we already know what is circular economy. There are two things. One is linear economy. What is linear economy? Where you have use, where you have manufacture, use, dispose, and the end product is waste. Okay, but what is circular economy? Circular economy is, you manufacture something, then you use it, then you use it as secondary raw material, and you again manufacture something, and you again manufacture something, and manufacture and manufacture until it reaches its full shelf life. Okay, third point is, high quality steel. The scrapping policy ensures that quality scrap is available for steel industry. If quality scrap is provided as the charge to the electric furnaces, then the furnaces can produce high grade steel. So automatically, if you give good quality scrap, there will be high grade steel. Authorized steel scrapping center. It promotes 6R's principle of reduce, reuse, recycle, recover, redesign and remanufacture through scientific handling, processing and disposal of all types of recyclable scraps, including non-ferrous scraps, through authorized centers or facility. So authorize these steel scrapping centers and bring them under the law. Hub and spoke model. To address the issue of collecting scrap and to structure the informal recycling sector based on environmental and scientific fronts, a hub and the spoke model has been suggested. A 4+1 hub and spoke model is suggested, where 4 collection and dismantling centers are to cater to 1 scrap processing centers. Okay, so there will be, what is hub and spoke? Where you have a single hub and then you have spokes. So there will be how many spokes? There will be 4 spokes. What those four spokes are going to do? They are going to do collection. Okay, they are going to do collection and dismantling. Okay, and when they bring it over here, this central hub will do the work of actual scrap processing. Okay, around 400 jobs would be created by one such composite unit. So this one such composite unit of hub and spoke will create how many jobs? 400 jobs. Interministerial Coordination Committee. An Interministerial Coordination Committee has been set up with Secretary, Ministry of Steel as conveyor, and Secretaries of Ministry of Road and Transport and Highways, Department of Heavy Industry, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Department of Revenue and Ministry of Labour and Employment as members. The mandate of the committee is, first is, policy changes required for creating an organized steel scrapping ecosystem. So we know we need policy changes and monitoring the operationalization and enforcement of relevant laws and regulations. So first of all, we saw we need to bring them and give them, accord them with the status of industry, so first is the status. Next is, we have to bring them under the law. So once we bring them under the law, we need to regulate them. So to regulate, they have created this such a big interministerial coordination committee, which will help in relevant laws and regulations in this regard, and the operationalization and enforcement. So once you bring the law, you need to enforce. Okay. So who all are there in this interministerial coordination committee? Department of Heavy Industry, Secretary, Ministry of Steel as conveyor, Secretaries of Ministries of Road and Transport, Highways, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, and Department of Revenue, Ministry of Labour, Employment as members. The mandate of the committee is, we saw, one is policy changes and monitoring the operationalization and enforcement of these relevant laws. Okay, so let's just revise this article quickly. So we started with what the Ministry of Steel is bringing, that is the steel scrap recycling policy. We saw what is primary raw material, iron ore, secondary is scrap. We saw that it is 100% recyclable infinitely. We also saw the steel production processes. There are three types: blast furnace, electric arc furnace and induction furnace. Blast furnace, you get normal hot molten iron and pig iron, and the primary raw material, that is iron ore, is used in this process. In the second process, 100% scrap can be used and it requires very less amount of energy. In the third process, it is cost effective technique, but it lacks in refining the steel, it just melts it. To regulate the scrap industry, we need to bring them under the ambit of industry, and we need to bring them under statutory law so that they have to comply to the safety norms. To improve steel production, we need to reduce the import bill. 725 million tons of domestic scrap and 7 million tons are imported. So we have the potential to harness that 7 million tons domestically itself instead of importing it. Because Japan, USA, China, they are continuously increasing. They are going from the primary route to using secondary raw material, that is scrap. Higher scrap availability currently, because per capita scrap consumption has increased from 33 kgs in 2004 to 60 kgs currently. Also, there are environmental benefits, because recycling steel requires 56% less energy than producing steel from iron ore. So 56% less energy plus 58% less emissions of carbon dioxide. Key features are environmental friendly, it promotes circular economy, high quality steel will be produced if the quality of scrap is high quality. Authorized steel scrapping centers, then we spoke about the hub and spoke model, that is have four centers of collection and dismantling, and then have one single center for scrap processing. Then we saw the inter-ministerial coordination committee that has two mandates. One is policy changes according to the steel scrapping ecosystem. And next is monitoring the operationalization and enforcement of the different laws that will be brought for regulation of this industry. So that's all for this article. Also, thank you very much for your time and patience. All the very best. So we have completed with the economy section of the November month of the Vision magazine. Thank you. Thank you very much.